The Liberty Nickel, or V Nickel, was replaced in 1913 by a coin with a new design, the Buffalo Nickel. James Fraser designed the coin with an American Indian obverse and a buffalo, or bison, on the reverse. Production of the Buffalo Nickel started in 1913. The date was placed on the highest part of the design, which is the first part to wear in circulation. As you can see in the example, the date is worn more quickly than the other features. Changes were made in 1913 to address some issues, primarily to make the date last longer. The date on the die was made deeper so that it would stand out more to mitigate the wearing issue. The 5 cents denomination was placed deeper into the coin by removing the hill the buffalo stands on. The original design is referred to as Type 1. The new design is Type 2. Fewer of the Type 2 coins were struck, so their valuation is generally higher than that of the Type 1. The price difference for P Mint coins is small, but for the D and S Mint coins, it is substantial. Buffalo Nickels are a popular series for collectors. The collection is challenging, but possible with time and patience. The table shows some of the more difficult issues to find. The 1937 D three-legged buffalo is widely publicized as a rarity, and most people have heard of it. Here's an example. You can see the hoof on the ground and the top of the leg without anything in between. Buffalo Nickels are a popular series for collectors. They are well known by the general population, more so than the Mercury Dime, for example. While buffaloes are not found in pocket change anymore, they are plentiful at shows and coin clubs. The series has a fairly low mintage, which portends higher prices eventually.